The second message is what's happening at the other official intergovernmental meeting with the ministers of health and education. I attended the morning session, and the way the minister spoke, I couldn't, and it's what, it was about sex education or sexuality education, I couldn't figure out what's the problem then. If everybody is doing the right thing, what is the problem? But they did mention some of the challenges, including implementation. But what is important, as my colleague Eric Hoffman, who is our representative in Mexico, just told us, there's a consensus on the declaration. It's going to be adopted right now. So your young people, read the declaration and go and hold your ministers of health and minister of education accountable to implement what they have signed and agreed upon here. That's the second message. The third message is your own accountability. You are all of us, including myself, are very privileged and honored to be here together. However, we all left behind us many groups of people, young and old, who have not been able to come here and express their voices. So we are all accountable to these people to ensure that whether in our programs or in your support, we have the voices of young people and older people, but we're talking about young people here, who are marginalized, who are discriminated against, whose society does not accept. We have to be the voices for them to bring them into the mainstream and to ensure that the rights are recognized and that they do not remain marginalized. Solidarity with them is what I'm asking you to do here. The fourth message is about, we were discussing just before we came in, we know you're all activists, they're all in civil society organizations of one way or another. And what we know is that when we engage with you, we engage with you to do programs. But we do not realize that in order for your work and for the institutions that you develop to be sustainable, we need to work with you to develop the capacities of these groupings to be institutions that have the proper skill to advocate, the proper skill to resource mobilize, to be able to get money, to negotiate, and to manage your programs and to be held accountable of how you run your organizations. So my colleagues and I also commit ourselves to looking at your organizations and seeing what are your needs as an institution to be able to continue the great work that you are doing. Two more messages. In our work and in the world of HIV and the world of sexual reproductive health, there has been a separation. We look at HIV alone, we look at sexual reproductive health alone. Voices have come together much more than ever before to bring sexual reproductive health and HIV AIDS together. And this is cost effective, it's how it should be, because HIV AIDS is mostly a sexual transmitted. So when you work on programs, always think, how do we bring sexual reproductive health programs, including family planning, with the whole spectrum of HIV AIDS prevention, treatment, care, and support. And the last message is that you are really professional people. And Ari and I were talking, we wished when we were your age, we were as professional and as committed as you are. So keep up the good work, continue to do what you are doing, and I think with you, the world will be a better world for sure. So thank you very much.